Hi, in this lecture I will tell you that how you can read and display an image in MATLAB. So this is about to read and display images in MATLAB. So what I will do is, there is a command. I'm going to create a variable I in which I will store the content of the image. The command imread will read all the pixel values of the image, and it will store that image in a variable I, which will actually be just like a matrix. Within this single quotation, I will write the path of the matrix. For example, I have this image that I am going to read. The path of this image within my directory is this one. This is the complete path from the root folder, which is C, to the image folder. This is the complete path. I will write this path over here, and after that I will write a slash, and then I will write the name of the image, and after that I will write the extension, which is jpg. So dot jpg. When I will execute this line, when I will execute this line of code, certain set of pixel values will appear within the MATLAB command window. You can see that there are many different values. These values are within the range of 0 to 255, and these values represent the intensity of the pixel. So you can see that most of the values over here that have been shown are near to 255. So 255 mean the very bright color in the image, like complete white color in the image, and intensity value 0 mean that the pixel is black. Since this is a color image, so the dimensionality of this image is 168 rows, 300 columns, and 3 channels. These three channels represent the red, green, and blue channel of the image. The name of the image is I. You can see that I contain different values, and each value have been accessed through these brackets. These show all the rows and all the columns of the first channel, and so all the rows and columns of the second and third channel have been displayed over here. Now I will tell you that how you can display this image. I am going to display the image. So what I will do is, I will write imshow image I. Now when this image code get executed, the image will be displayed. This was the color image of a cat. So this is a black cat, and the background is blue, and some portion of this image is purely white. Now I want to convert this image into grayscale, which has only one channel in it. I am going to convert it into gray, im_gray is equal to, this is the name of the variable, im2gray. I think this was the command. So you will see what happened. I think this is RGB to gray. The command is actually RGB to gray. Now you can see that im to gray command, RGB to gray command, has converted it, the image, into grayscale image, and the dimensionality of this image is as similar as the color image, but the number of channel is one. There is only one channel within this image. this is the unsigned integer 8. Unsigned integer 8 mean the value can be from the range 0 to 255, because the 255 is the maximum value of the unsigned integer and the 0 is the lowest value of the unsigned integer. The size of each pixel will be 8 bit. So if I want to calculate the size of this image, which is grayscale, then what I will do is I will write 168 multiplied by 300 multiplied by 8. So the total number of bits are 4,03,200. So if I want to calculate that how many KB of image is this, so I want to convert it into that how many KBs are there within this image. So I will divide it into 1024. So it is 393 kilobyte. This is the size of this image. Similarly, if I want to calculate the size of the color image, I will multiply this number by 3. So the size of this image is within MBs. So I will divide it by 1024, because the total number of 1024 KB are there in 1 MB. So the image is about 1.1536 MB. This is a complete method to read an image, convert that image into grayscale, and display that image. Let me show you the pixel values of the gray scale image. You can see that over here the values are almost near to 200, and within the center, like this is the center of the image. Since the color of the cat is black, so these values are going to be near zero. For example, 57 is more near to zero, which is black color, than the 255, which is white color. Like in the corner, you will see that the values are more near to 255, which is a white color, pure white color. Now we will display the grayscale image, that how it look like. I will write the name of the grayscale image, which is I am gray, and you will be, I will close the previous figure and then I will display this image. You can see this is a grayscale image, this is a black and white image. So now I want to show you the histogram of this grayscale image. So I will write I am hist, and I will show you that how this grayscale image histogram look like. I will close the previous figure and I will call this command. So you can see that the zero intensity over here, it has been written as zero, and at the extreme right end of the x-axis over here it has been written as 250. If you go closer to the far end of this axis, you will see that 255 have been written over here. You can see that this is the histogram of the grayscale image. These values represent the number of pixel intensity, the frequency of each pixel intensity. So the number of pixel intensity, or the frequency of 100 intensity, is about 200, and intensity of 50 is about 50. The intensity of 75 is about 100, and the intensity of 200 is about 25 or something stuffs. And you can see that there are 250, the intensity of 250 is about 900. so that how many times within the complete set of image this specific value repeats itself. Histogram represent all the phenomena like that. Now let me show you something more. I want to show a specific portion of the grayscale image. The actual size of the grayscale image is 168, and I want to show the left side of this image, that how the left side of the image look like. You can see there are a total of 168 rows, so I will write a single colon over here, and I will write from 1 to, here are 300, so I will write from 1 to 150. So it will display all the rows, and in the column section it will show the left portion, which is from 100 and from 1 to 150. You can see this is a complete left portion of the image. If I want to display the right portion of this image, I will write from 150 to 300, so it will display the right side of the image. If I want to display the from 1 to 168, so I want to display the top left portion of the image, of this image. I'll close and I will run this command. You can see this is the top right section of the image. So by changing these index values, I can display any segment of the image. So this was all about to read, display an image, and access a certain portion of the image, and conversion from RGB to grayscale. And note one thing, that there is no way back. If I convert an image from RGB to grayscale, then there is no way to convert a grayscale image back into color image. So this thing should be noted. Thank you so much.